The name of the show is Profiles with Malone and Mantz, and we profile the greatest filmmakers of all time. And this show, we are profiling the work of the great Terence Malick.
Yes. Right.
So thank you so much for joining us.
But you know, if you're profiling just the greatest filmmakers of all time, you must have like six shows and then you're done.
No.
No, we have so many.
This
is
our 49th. Films.
Oh, you're quite open-minded about who the greatest filmmakers are.
Yeah. Well, Kurosawa.
You got Kurosawa, you got John Williams, composers.
Okay. You're not necessarily interviewing them.
No. No.
Sometimes
all right,
we
so
are.
You might be interviewing about filmmakers past.
Yeah, we had a Hitchcock show and we had three Hitchcock blondes call in to talk to us about Hitchcock.
Where can I see this?
YouTube.
It's on the Popcorn Talk Network. But we're going to make it easy for you. I'm going to send the link to the show to Jen and she'll forward it to you. So, right? She's got this down and you got this down. But, you know, we profiled.
That's quite interesting.
We profiled Nolan.
You did a piece on Kurosawa?
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. And a lot of people watching the show.
Thanks.
Who had never seen a Kurosawa movie,
right.
After hearing us talk about Kurosawa, they're like...
They still haven't. And they rushed out.
They rushed out. They're like, I never saw Seven Samurai. I never saw Rashomon until you guys were talking about it. So now we're talking about Malick's movies, and you've now, including the next one, you've now done three.
And I remember when I was a teenager, I saw Badlands, and I felt like my head kind of exploded a bit.
Yeah, it's so wonderful.
So I'm curious...
Space
so great.
And Terry's in it.
Yeah.
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 Answering the door. That was quite funny because the actor just didn't turn up that day. But he told me that he couldn't stop giggling the whole way through.
Really?
Because he realized suddenly when you're actually in the scene how much actors are just kind of heightening the reality. So he said he couldn't stop laughing all the time throughout.
So what was your first experience with Terence Malick's work and what struck you the most about his style?
I went to see a double feature at some place that does kind of cheap theatre in LA, and it was Badlands and Days of Heaven. And I had a similar experience to what you said, you know, with Badlands, just loving it. I was down, I was very depressed about something that happened, and my wife took me down to Chile to kind of backpack around. And I got, on the same day, I got these emails, in its infancy, like I barely check emails now, but I got, and Terry doesn't use emails, but I got an email from Werner Herzog saying, hey, did I want to go make a film with him? And I was like, oh yeah, I love Werner. And then from Terry saying, would I just go, not to meet with him, but just to read something for him. You know, you often read scripts for a director and they have no intention of casting you ever in the film, but they just want to hear it out loud. And so I said, oh, I agree. So then I met up with Terry. I had auditioned for The Thin Red Line. I've gotten it, but I never met him. And then, you know, met with Terry, sat and read, and then he did actually, you know, call back and say, actually, you know, I think there's a role for you in The New World, and I'd love to, you know, have you play John Rolfe. And so that's how it started, and I just love his company, love his approach to filmmaking, and we kept in touch, and then, you know, we ended up doing Night of Cups.
You know, when it comes to a movie like The New World, I feel like it's a film that's been 11 years since it came out. It really grows on you, and it means new things every time you see it. But for you, like, what was it like working with him on that first movie, and what did you make of his? He sort of has an unconventional directing style.
Yeah, but I'm very comfortable with the way that he likes to work, because initially, I started quite late on that film. And I knew some of the crew, and I would call them and say, so how's it going, what are they doing? And they said, well, there's a lot of improvisation. And I'm thinking, oh God, this is the 1600s. So I was in London, and I headed down to the British Library, and I was just going through everything I could, because I thought, I've got to have all the language down, I've got to know the exact history, I've got to know everything. And I was thinking, oh my God, this is gonna be a massive volume of information I've got to remember. And then found, not in the slightest. When you get there, you know, Terry's all about, you know, just sincerity. At that point, he did have a script for The New World, but most of the time would just sort of throw it out. But, you know, yes, he wanted a lot of improvisation, but understood that an awful lot of it wouldn't be useful. I mean, for instance, I remember I made the mistake of having John Rolfe actually
discover the concept of gravity before Newton did, because there was a scene and Terry told me to improvise and I explained gravity and he said that was great, but Newton hadn't actually done that yet, so you know, we just kind of changed history there. But the thing that's very different from Terry is there's a lot of directors and they want to rehearse beforehand, and look, there's benefits to both, you know, I'm not saying one is better than the other, it's just different, and Terry's on his journey. But for Terry, rehearsing kind of kills it. So he wants you to, he's filming, the motto's kind of film before we're ready. Like he says, you ready? No, great, go. Because he likes to have that spontaneity of trying to figure it out as you go, not having a goal at the end of each scene, so you're not sort of having that sense of achievement at the end, so it's more kind of, let's see what happens. I would often, I like to fall asleep on set, it's just something I sort of enjoy doing, and so he would sometimes just film me asleep or then just wake me up and say, hey, go into that other room and start talking with so-and-so, and I would walk in kind of bleary-eyed, not really knowing, and just start talking with them, and wow. And you see what happens, or he would come to me and he'd recognize that, okay, this scene, we were starting to repeat ourselves. You know, literally, in that you could see the actor was starting to find his groove in the scene, which most directors go, great, 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 now we're starting to find it, now we got something. And Terry's the opposite. He goes, all right, now it's ruined, because now you sort of are trying to get it right, and right. We should never have that sense. So he would just say to me, well, where do you want to go shoot this? And I would go, you know what, I think that I would go walk under that tree and film. So we go do that. And he's so collaborative and really loves new ideas. He loves working with people. He has incredibly experienced people working with him. You know, Chiba being one of his, yeah. You know, main collaborators. Oh, yeah. Jack Fisk as well. You know, but he also really likes to have absolute beginners as well, and have that kind of sense of discovery and people who don't have any technique. I think he's kind of anti-technique. So it's lovely. It was a great experience. And then with Night of Cups, we just took it a step further where he went, you know what, we've kept on throwing the script out on the New World. How about we just don't even have a script for
so
this one?
So did you know how it would end up looking at all?
No, not at all. You know, I mean, he would sometimes give me a GoPro and just send me off with the other actors, and we'd go shoot a scene by ourselves about whatever. Or go in the ocean and shoot something, and I'd just bring back the GoPro, he'd have a look, and it was either, Christian, there's nothing we can use here, or, oh, that's a lovely moment there you got. And, you know, you never knew who he was filming, you know, even if it might be I never have much to say in Night of Cups. Most of the time he wanted me to be quiet and just and listen. Exactly. He's a man of words who's kind of lost the ability to use words.
Yeah, I like that.
And so every day was a complete surprise. You know, I went in, you know, you got to just be comfortable with going and going, I have no idea what I'm going to be doing today.
A lot of our viewers and listeners are a little younger, and they might not know Terence Malick's movies. Mm. And the whole purpose is for us to introduce them. So what kind of advice would you give to viewers and listeners to sort of bring them into Terence Malick's world?
Just be a bit bold. Don't go for the normal stuff that, you know, that is playing at your local Cineplex. Like, be a bit more adventurous, you know. Go and see what other emotions and experiences film can bring to you, because Terry approaches it in a very different manner. So, yeah. You know, be adventurous, be bold. It's so worth it. You've got one of the, as you guys were saying, one of the absolute best American filmmakers of all time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Oh, thanks so much for joining us.
So interesting. That was great.
That was cool. That gets a high five.
Woo!
We didn't have one of those in a while.
I know, yeah.
Very, very good. This is just a conversation, you know?
It was great.
And we were his first interview that day.
Yeah.